In the previous movie, we created a set of controls for our hips and shoulders, fixed our rotation orders, and added the ability to twist the torso. In this movie, we'll add some FK controls to the rig to give us more nuanced manipulation of the spine. Open the file Character Rigging Part 4 Start, or continue using your own file from the previous lesson. The IK, or inverse kinematics, spine we set up here works by taking your shoulder or hip manipulations and rotating each spine joint accordingly, creating a natural bend. The caveat is that although we know the spine will bend, we don't always have a lot of control over exactly how it will bend. For example, we can't bend the top of the spine more than the bottom, or vice versa. FK, or forward kinematics, will give us direct control of the spine rotation. First, we're going to be setting up our FK controls on a completely different joint chain. We do this because the IK spline has removed our ability to tweak the existing spine joints directly. In any case, it's better to separate the two solutions anyway, in case we want to replace one or the other later down the line. Select the joint tool and go to the side view. Hold V for point snapping and click drag near the hip joint to create a new joint directly on top of it. Now create three more joints that roughly follow your result spine, with the last joint snapped to the shoulder joint. As before, you can use the insert key to adjust the position of the spine joints if you wish. Rename the first and last joints hip FK joint and shoulder FK joint, and the ones in between spine 1 FK joint and spine 2 FK joint. Like in the previous movie, we'll need to make sure the joint orientations are set properly. In particular, we want to make sure that they match the same orientation as our controls. So select the FK bones and go to the Skeleton Orient Joint Options window. Remember, the orientation uses the Y-axis as the primary, with the Z-axis facing forward. We'll also change the rotation order to YZX. This will keep the twist correctly oriented at all times, which is highly useful for the middle of the torso. Now, to make this new FK chain control the torso, first group the shoulder control and hip control to themselves in a shoulder FK const group and hip FK const group. Now parent constrain shoulder FK const group to shoulder FK joint and hip FK const group to hip FK joint. Now if you select either the spine 1 or spine 2 FK joints and rotate them, the torso rotates along with it. Note that these FK joints are actually controlling the rotation of the controls, which in turn control the bend of the spline, which then affects the geometry. So what we have here is not really a fully FK solution, like we will show you with the arms and legs in the later movies of this series, but more of a hybrid solution. Still, it gives us the precise control we wanted. However, just like the bind joints we created in the previous movie, it's kind of awkward to select the FK spine joints as they are now. Let's create some control curves to make that process easier. While IK control curves tend to differ from artist to artist, FK controls are mostly set up as NURBS circles. Go to the Create NURBS Primitives menu and turn off Interactive Creation. Create a NURBS circle and scale it up so it's roughly larger than the character's torso. Freeze the transformations when you're done. Rename the circle Spine 1 FK Control. Now, how do we get this circle's rotation attribute to control the rotation of its respective FK joint? A first reaction might be to just use point snapping to move it up to the joint and then parent it into the FK joint hierarchy. While this would seem to give us the behavior we want, there's a problem. If you rotate the control in this kind of setup, the circle's transform node is what's rotating, not the FK joint itself. This is bad, as it leads to confusion about what is actually in control here. It also breaks the hierarchy, which makes things confusing for those who might use your rig down the line. Instead, we're going to extract the circle's shape node and parent that to our joint, which doesn't have its own shape node. First, go to the display menu in the outliner and turn on shapes. Now you can expand the Spine 1 FK control node to see its shape node underneath. Select the shape node and control select the Spine 1 FK joint. In the MEL command line, type parent-r-s. This tells Maya to parent the shape node to the joint, maintaining its relative position to its parent. The curve moves to the joint's position. You can make further curve adjustments by going into the Control Vertex Component mode, selecting all the vertices, and then transforming them all at once. Now repeat the last few steps to create a new curve for the Spine 2 FK joint. Again, we'll use the Control Vertex Component mode to adjust the shape and position of this curve without impacting the FK joints. While we're at it, let's also rename the two Spine FK joints. Since we're going to be controlling them directly via these circles, we'll change their joint suffix to Control. Once you're done, you can delete the leftover transform nodes. As a final bit of cleaning up, let's put the two IK controls into a layer and color them yellow. And put the two FK controls in a layer and color them blue. Now we can control the torso from the hips, shoulders, or anywhere in between. This is looking pretty good, but notice what happens when we try to move the IK controls around. While the torso does its best to stay in line with the control, it just can't reach that far. In the next movie, we'll explore how to add squash and stretch functionality to the torso so it can scale to reach both controls, no matter where they are in the scene.